This is Miss Ping, in a back alley near Stockholm, Sweden. And danger's in the air. Sharpening his knives is slightly Mad Max. They're entertainers with the Toonbar Ping Pong Show. This clandestine troupe paddles much more than ping pong balls.
Hitting knives with ping pong paddles? All right, that's pretty impressive.
I love this video. I applaud every effort that they took to make this video look this way.
And this stunt is helping the Toonbar Ping Pong Show become a bit of a sensation online.
Right now, we're at the secret training facility for the Toonbar Ping Pong Show.
They're from Toonbar, a town about 25 kilometers from Stockholm.
They train every day. This is what they do.
Jim says it requires intense preparation to perform the stunts.
They're incredibly dangerous, and there have been accidents.
Miss Ping is the group's first female guest star.
Who volunteers to be the woman with the ping pong paddles?
She's fearless. It's incredibly dangerous. If there's a mistake, she could lose a finger, a hand. She could lose a head. She could lose her life.
This is the team's most dangerous trick to date, and it warrants a closer look.
If you even ever tried to throw a knife into a target, you hold the blade or you hold the handle and you're spinning it end over end. The way that those knives are hit is giving them a rotation that should wobble as it goes through the air.
Slightly Mad Max has a very different approach, one that might break the laws of physics.
I don't think he's quite applying the right amount of force that you would need to get that knife going in the same sort of trajectory that he has in the video.
I don't believe, based on what we saw in the frame, that that would have happened the way it was shown.
Our experts are mixed on whether this is real or a ruse.
The fact is, there are people who can throw knives incredibly accurately from great distances. This seems completely plausible to me. Ridiculously incredible, but plausible.
Examining the video in slow motion reveals more.
You can see that her skirt gets lifted up by something, and it is in direct correlation with the one paddle. That could happen if the knife were already in the paddle.
I think we see a hit on his side, and I think we see a catch on her side, but I don't think the time gap in between is the appropriate time gap for the force he'd be hitting those objects.
We think we see the knife flying through the air. The question is, do we actually see the knife flying through the air?
He's dropped the original knife, and they've added a 3D knife flying from his paddle to her paddle in compositing and visual effects.
And the second paddle is clearly skewered before the flying knife arrives.
Massing out the tip of a knife on a paddle is very easy to manipulate in visual effects. So the knife is already there, you just don't see it until she flips to the backside of the knife.
Also, it does appear that the pineapple is severed before the knife makes contact.
You didn't have any kind of momentary delay from the knife actually slicing through it. It may not even go all the way to the other end of the pineapple, honestly, when it goes off. And the pineapple is too clean of a cut for this situation.
It would be very easy in visual effects to have that pineapple already split and on a wire. The wall in the background is a great texture to be able to mask the string out of the shot in visual effects.
Even the ping pong ball appears to take off two impossible frames early.
Wait a minute, let's see that again.
So is the Toonbar team's true talent slicing fruit with ping pong paddles or splicing video with special effects? Either way, their stunts attract millions of viewers online.
I think it is some kind of sleight of hand, but you know what? I had to watch this a few times in order to actually figure that out.
I love to see this kind of thing. Keep it up. The more special effects, the better.